Yeah, I did kickboxing for a while, but I wasn't very good at all. It wasn't my sport sort of thing. And I was at home watching Rocky IV, believe it or not. And I says to my mum and my stepdad, I said, I'm gonna do that. And they laughed. I said, no, I said, I'm gonna do that. So then I went to the gym, and I remember my first memory is 2 days before a fight, or 3 days. The trainer, I was messing about in the gym, and the trainer actually says to me, you're gonna lose. And I lost. So I started watching Rocky, and never really too serious. No one ever thought I was ever going to do anything, and that's what drove me on. People saying, you're not going to stick at it, you're going to pack in, you're going to quit, it'll be too hard for you. And then obviously I proved them wrong, which is something I'm very happy about. Yeah, my last fight was on Leeds Arena. I've just signed with Frank Warren, so I think it was my second fight. It's my second fight with Warren, so and it was a knockout win as well. And I said before the fight I had to make a statement on a big show, and luckily I did that. And I think a fight that's most important to me in my professional career is it's probably my debut. You know, because you never, like I say, where I started, I never thought I was ever going to be anywhere near where I am now. So my debut, just sort of being there and having a professional license, that's probably meant a lot to me. It's brilliant, especially where I come from. You know, I'm just off an estate. You know, I'm no, you know, it's not like I've been brought up spoon-fed. You know, I've been brought up well by my mum and my stepdad. So to sort of give something back, you know, from a sport that's given me a lot, you know, already. So you know, hopefully people can learn off you know what I've told them and what I've shown them, and they can get to the top one day. Yeah, I think stick at it. There's gonna be times where it's hard, and there's gonna be times where you have to go training, but you really don't want to. You know, just stick at it. And if anyone tells you can't do it, you know, have that in your head and prove them wrong. And even vice versa, if someone's got a son out there that's doing it and they don't think they're gonna be very good, you know, don't say that to them. You know, drive them on, spur them on. Everyone's different. I reacted different. I reacted where I was like, right, I'm gonna prove you wrong now. But other people can sort of go in a shell and sort of be like, oh, I don't want to do it anymore. And who knows who they could be in the future. So I think, you know, if you're doing boxing, stick at it, work hard, and you know, it will pay off one day. I think from who I used to go around with and stuff like that, I could have been in a very different position now. But I think I've met some brilliant friends in boxing. People who I've boxed, people who I've just been to show with. You know, I was on the England team as an amateur. You know, in the old days, I'll never forget. I think it's brilliant. You know, I think having all different disciplines on a show is massive. I mean, because some people may not be a boxing fan, but they may be an MMA fan. You know, and vice versa. Some people might not be keen on MMA, but like boxing. And if you can go to, it's very rare you can go to a show and witness both. You know, I've definitely never been to a show and witnessed both, apart from at a combat challenge. And also as a boxer, when I go to the shows, you also, you know, I see the MMA guys and the groundwork, and you know, you sort of look and pick up little things as well. I mean, I may never use it, but if I ever wanted, you know, I know the MMA training is very hard. So, you know, maybe one day I'll do a session and see what it's like, yeah.